Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday, the feast of Saint Cornelius and Saint Cyprian. Our mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance antiphon. Holy men shed their glorious blood for the Lord. They loved Christ in their life. They imitated him in their death, and therefore were crowned in triumph.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who gave Saints Cornelius and Cyprian to your people as diligent shepherds and valiant martyrs, grant through their intercession we may be strengthened in faith and constancy, and spend ourselves without reserve for the unity of the Church. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Beloved, let no one have contempt for your youth, but set an example for those who believe in speech, conduct, love, faith, and purity. Until I arrive, attend to the reading, exhortation, and teaching. Do not neglect the gift you have, which was conferred on you through the prophetic word with the imposition of hands by these presbyterate. Be diligent in these matters. Be absorbed in them, so that your progress may be evident to everyone. Attend to yourself and to your teaching. Persevere in both tasks, for by doing so, you will save both yourself and those who listen to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. How great are the works of the Lord.
How great are the works of the Lord.
The works of his hands are faithful and just. Sure are all his precepts, reliable forever and ever, wrought in truth and equity.
How great are the works of the Lord.
He has sent deliverance to his people. He has ratified his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name.
How great are the works of the Lord.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Prudent are all who live by it. His praise endures forever.
How great are the works of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A certain Pharisee invited Jesus to dine with him, and he entered the Pharisee's house and reclined at table. Now there was a sinful woman in the city who learned that he was at table in the house of the Pharisee. Bringing an alabaster flask of ointment, she stood behind him at his feet weeping and began to bathe his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and anointed them with the ointment. When the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, "If this man were a prophet, he would know who and what sort of woman this is who is touching him, that she is a sinner." Jesus said to him in reply, "Simon, I have something to say to you." "Tell me, teacher," he said. "Two people were in debt to a certain creditor. One owed 500 days' wages, and the other 50. Since they were unable to repay the debt, he forgave it both. He forgave it for both. Which of them will love him more? Simon said in reply, "The one, I suppose, whose larger debt was forgiven." He said to him, "You have judged rightly." Then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? When I entered your house, you did not give me water for my feet, but she has bathed them with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You did not give me a kiss, but she has not ceased kissing my feet since the time I entered. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she anointed my feet with ointment. So I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven. Hence she has shown great love. But the one to whom little is forgiven loves little." He said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." The others at table said to themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" But he said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, when you take a look at the Gospel for today, it's a rather dramatic Gospel, no? And I'd like to invite you to reflect on sin, forgiveness, and gratitude, no? Those three things, no? You know, one of the things that I think I shared with you that I have this weekly prayer group, and we're following the book Only Your Grace, no? And this last several weeks we were talking about sin, forgiveness, and freedom, no? I think one of the goals of spiritual life really is freedom, no? Spiritual freedom. And a great part of that journey to spiritual freedom is that we come to terms with our sins. Yung harapin natin yung ating pagkamakasalanan, harapin natin yung ating mga kasalanan, at harapin natin yung ating mga nagawang pagkakamali, ano? Yun yung unang punto sa sin, no? Kagaya nitong babae sa ebanghelyo, na makita natin na siya ay buong pagkumbabang kumbaga kinukumpisal niya sa Panginoon na siya ay isang makasalanan, no? But I think it is the acknowledgement of one's sin that is the first step, no? And mahirap kasi yung tanggapin natin yung ating pagkakamali, no? Palagay ko kung minsan natatanggap natin sa ating sarili, pero mahirap na ikumpisal, no? It's hard to confess it either in the confessional or even to people, especially the people that we have offended, no? And yet I think dahil nga itong babae sa ebanghelyo, because the woman came to Christ with all humility, no? And was really begging for his forgiveness, and you could see that she was doing everything, no, to show her repentance and to ask for forgiveness, no? And I guess that is the Lord now gives that forgiveness, no? Because the Lord sees how the woman has in all humility accepted her sinfulness, and so the Lord grants the forgiveness. Yung pagpapatawad kasi ay ano yan eh, sabi nga ng maraming manunulat, ano, na spiritual writers, na ang biyaya ng pagpapatawad ng Diyos ay laging nandyan. Pero kailanman hindi yon ipipilit sa atin ng Diyos. That the grace of God's forgiveness is always available. And all we need to do is turn to that grace and to ask for the grace and to allow the grace to enter our lives. In the same way that this woman now asks for that grace, and you see how Christ, you know, with so much compassion and love for her, gives her the forgiveness. And then finally, you know, so it is the acknowledgement of sin, the asking and the receiving of forgiveness, and then finally the freedom. And here you see the Lord now, you know, making that declaration, no, very very clearly, no. In fact, pinagtanggol ng Panginoon, no, yung babaeng makasalanan do sa mga namimintas, no. Hindi lang pinagtanggol ng Panginoon ang sarili niya, kundi pinagtanggol niya yung babaeng makasalanan na humihingi ng patawad, at pinupuri niya yung babae kung doon sa pagpapakita ng kanyang pag
ng paghingi ng pagpatawad, no? The Lord praises this woman's repentance, no, and her humility to ask for the Lord's forgiveness. And then the final grace is the freedom that the woman was given, no? And you see that at the very end of the gospel. But he said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." That is the freedom of the forgiven sinner. That is the freedom of the sinner who turns to Christ and accepts that forgiveness. The freedom to live our lives in peace, but the freedom to live our lives in the grace of the Lord. So today let us pray. No? Let us pray for these blessings. The blessing and the grace to acknowledge our sins. The blessing and the grace to open our hearts and to accept the forgiveness of God. And in doing so, to experience the freedom that this brings. The freedom now that allows us to become real and genuine followers of Christ. And perhaps in such a way to witness to the mercy of God by bringing people to this forgiveness of Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. A sinful woman in the city anointed Jesus' feet in thanksgiving for receiving God's forgiveness. May the graces we have received from God make us humble and thankful. With confidence we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
May we thank the Lord for forgiving us many times in the past and even to the present. May we express our gratefulness by becoming more loving. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we show great love to the Lord and to our brothers and sisters, for love covers a multitude of sins. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we not look down and despise sinners, but encourage them to turn and find the road that leads to the merciful Father. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer. And again, let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together, dasalin natin sabay-sabay ang panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa halalang 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami, lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina, higit sa anumang interes sa pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ng aming mga isip at puso, nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer,
fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, we ask you to receive us and to be pleased with the sacrifice that we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, watch over my intercession. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offerings of your people in honor of the passion of your holy martyrs, Saint Cornelius and Cyprian, and may the gifts that gave them courage under persecution make us too steadfast in all trials through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Cyprian and Saint Cornelius, the martyrs, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love, to overcome our fear of sickness and death, and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love for and service to one another. Guide their experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Through these mysteries which you have received, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that by the example of the martyrs, Saints Cornelius and Cyprian, we may be strengthened with the fortitude of your Spirit to bear witness to the truth of the gospel through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming salamat po and have a good day. Thank you.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta, at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every dioceses. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating Educational Assistance Program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Bontoc, Basilan, Hulo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato, at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.